The fifth unit of basics of GST covers the liability to pay tax and liability to pay tax in specified cases and also transitional provisions. The liability to pay tax is a registered person who receives goods and services from an unregistered person will be liable to pay tax on such receipt of supply. Small businesses having turnover below the threshold limit can, however, voluntarily opt to register and pay taxes and comply like a normal taxpayer. And who are liable to pay tax? The following categories of persons will be liable to pay GST. Person registered under GST and making taxable supplies under GST. Persons registered under GST required to make payment of tax under reverse charge mechanism. E-commerce operators registered under GST and through whom certain categories of notified supplies are made. The persons registered under GST and required to deduct tax, the TDS. The e-commerce operators registered under GST and required to collect tax, TCS. The liability of tax pay in a specified cases. A buyer is liable to pay tax under reverse charge in case of receipt of specified goods or services or both from an unregistered person. And all the provisions of the Act shall apply to the buyer as if he is a person liable for paying the tax in relation to the supply of goods or services or both. The responsibility shifted to the buyers. Reverse charge mechanism, self-invoice, input tax credit, e-way bill in case of purchase from an unregistered person, import of goods and services, goods supplied free of cost to the contractor to incorporate it in the concessions. These all are the responsibilities shifted to the buyer. So mentioned in the liability of tax to pay. In discuss the liability in case of transfer of business in details. First of all, who is liable to pay tax in case of transfer of business? Section 85, subsection 1, joint and several liabilities where a taxable person liable to pay tax under this Act transfer his business in whole or in part by sale, gift, lease, leave and license, hire or in any other manner whatsoever. The taxable person and the person to whom the business is so transferred shall jointly and severally be liable whole or as the case may be to the extent of such transfer to pay the tax or interest or any penalty due from the taxable person up to the time of such transfer, whether such tax, interest or penalty has been determined before such transfer, but has remained unpaid is or determined thereafter. These all are the liability in case of the transfer of business. And liability of agent and principal. Section 86 mentioned the where an agent supplies or receives any taxable goods on behalf of his principal, such agent and his principal shall be jointly and severely liable to pay the tax payable on such goods under this Act. Under Section 87, liability in case of amalgamation or mergers. What is the tax liability for companies undergoing amalgamation or mergers? When two or more companies are amalgamated or merged by the order of court or tribunal or otherwise, and the order is to take effect from a date earlier to the date of the order, and any two or more of such companies have supplied or received any goods and services to or from each other during the period commencing on the date from which the order takes effects. Under Section 88, liability in case of liquidations. At the time of liquidations, what are the liability of the taxpayers? The taxpayer dues in case of company under liquidations, the intimation of appointment to commissioner. It must be intimation appointment to the commissioners. After that, notification to liquidators. And finally, liquidation of private companies, Section 88. When any private company is wound up and any tax, interest or penalty determined under this Act on the company for any period should pay the liability of taxations. And Section 89 mentioned the liability of directors of private company. What are the liability of director of private company is, where any tax, interest or penalty due from a private company in respect of any supply of goods or services must pay the tax or liable to pay the tax. And what shall be done when a private company has been converted into public company? Section 89, subsection 2, where a private company is converted into a public company and the tax, interest or penalty in respect of any supply of goods or services or both for any period during which such company was a private company cannot be recovered before such conversions, then nothing contained in subsection of 1 shall apply to any persons who was directors of such private company in relation to any tax. The section 90, liability in case of the partnership. The liable to pay tax dues in case of a partnership firm is where any firm is liable to pay any tax, interest. Where any partners retired from the firm, he or the firm shall intimate the date of retirement is very important. And if no such intimations is given within 1 month from the date of retirement, the liability of such partner shall continue until the date on which such intimation is received by the commissioner. So, is the liability to pay the tax or any amount penalties? Or what are the liability in other situations? The business carried on through guardians, trustees or court of wards, some other liabilities of other situations is Section 91, where the business in respect of which any tax, already mentioned the tax, interest, penalty if payable under the Act is carried on the guardians or trustees. Before that mentioned the company as well as the persons liable to pay the tax or other situations. And also having some removal of difficulties. What are the removal of difficulties is? In case of death of a person carrying on business and pay tax in partition of HUF and pay tax in dissolution of firms and pay tax in termination of guardianships and pay tax in case of discontinuation of business by firm, HUF and AOB. So the above provisions applicable to the LP. These all are the liability to pay tax. On the final topics of transitional provisions. The transitional provisions of section 142 mentioned in the GST of transitional provisions. This also migration of existing taxpayers. Section 139 notification number 1 2017 mentioned the migrations. The provisional certificate of registration be issued on the appointed day. If yes, what are the conditions? From the appointed day, every person registered under any of the existing laws and having a valid permanent account number shall be issued a certificate of registration on provisional basis subject to such conditions. And a final certificate of registration will be issued. The final certificate of registration shall be granted in such form and manner and subject to such conditions as may be prescribed in section 139. So also to take input tax credit under section 140 is composition levy of the taxations. So in the transactional provisions is arrangements for ITC, right, one by one mention the closing balance of the credit in the lost returns, unavailed credit on capital goods, credit on duty paid stock, credit on duty paid stock when registered person does not possess the document evidencing payment of excise duty or VAT. The credit relating to exempted goods under the existing law which are now taxable is the transactional provisions. And input services in transit. Tax paid under the existing law under composition scheme, the ITC in case of centralized registration under service tax. Reclaim the reversed input service credit where any goods or capital goods belonging to the principal are lying at the premises of the agent on the appointed day. Next B is transactional provisions relating to job work and goods returned, sent on approval, etc. The job work, already we have discussed about the unit 3 is what is job work and e-commerce. The goods removed before 6 months of the appointed day, that is 1st July 2017, but returned within the 6 months from the 1st July 2017. And third is section B, goods sent on approval basis before 6 months of the appointed day, that is 1st July 2017, but returned within 6 months from 1st July 2017. And fourth one is TDS deducted in VAT. And price revisions in respect of existing contracts. And the last categories of this transactional provision is the proceedings under the existing laws, GST law has become operational with the effect from 1st July 2017. And existing laws have been repealed. The elaborate provisions have been made to save the pending as well as future claims relating to existing law made before on or after the appointed day, that is 1st July 2017. Such proceedings may pertain to refund claims of SEN VAT, credit or VAT, or export related to rebate or service tax. Such proceedings may either result in recovery of tax or a refund. All such cases would be disposed of under the existing law. If any claim for refund of SEN VAT, SEN VAT is a central value added tax, credit is fully or partially rejected. The amount so rejected shall lapse. Refund of SEN VAT credit shall be paid in cash. There will be no refund of SEN VAT if already carry forwarded. If any amount becomes recoverable, the same shall be recovered or arrears of tax under GST Act. Statutory provisions relating to transactionals are contained in Chapter 20, Section 139 to Section 142 of the CGST Act 2017, SG Act 2017, and Rule 117 to 121 of the CGST Rules 2017. The Transactional Provisions Rules 1117 of CGST, tax or duty credits carried forward under any existing law or on goods held in stock on the appointed day. Every registered person entitled to take credit of input tax under Section 140 shall within 90 days of the appointed day submit a declaration electronically in form of GST TRAN-1 duly signed on the common portal, specifying therein separately the amount of input tax credit to which he is entitled under the provision of the said sections. What the section is? The 1117. And provided that the commissioner may, on the recommendation of the council, extend the period of 90 days by a further period not exceeding 90 days. Provided further that where the inputs have been received from an export-oriented unit or unit located in electronic hardware technology, the credit shall be allowed to the extent as provided in Rule 3, Subsection 7 of the SEN VAT Credit Rules 2004. These provisions only in CGST rules. And in the case of the claim under Section 140 is mentioned the central sales tax in 1956. And a registered persons who was not registered under the existing law under CGST is, a registered person shall be allowed to avail input tax credit on goods. Such credit shall be allowed at the rate of 60% on such goods which attract central tax at the rate of 9% or more than 40%. The scheme shall be availed for 6 tax periods from the appointed dates. And the registered person who was not registered under the existing law under the SGST rules is, a registered persons, Section 3 of 140 shall be allowed to avail input tax credit on goods held in stock on the appointed day in respect of which he is not in possession of any document. And rule 118 of CGST mentioned the declaration to be made under section 142 subsection 11c. Every person to whom the provisions class C of subsection 11 of section 142 applies shall within a period of 90 days of the appointed day submit a declaration electronically in form GST Tran 1, that is TRAN Transition 1. The individual state may insert a proviso giving the details of methodology of calculation of the VAT paid, which would be availed in ITC of state tax. The rule 119 of CGST rules declaration of stock held by principal. Every person to whom the provisions of section 141 apply shall within 90 days of the appointed day submit a declaration electronically in form GST TRAN 1 specifying therein the stock of the inputs, semi-finished goods or finished goods as applicable held by him on the appointed day. And the rule 120 of CGST details of goods sent on approval basis. Every person having sent goods on approval under the earlier law and to whom section 142 subsection 12 applies shall within 90 days of the appointed day submit detail of such goods sent on approval in form GST TRAN 1. And final rule 121 of CGST rules 2017, recovery of credit wrongly availed. The amount credit in rule 117 subsection 3 may be verified under proceedings under section 73 or as the case may be section 74 shall be initiated in respect of any credit wrongly availed in whether wholly or partially. So there are only mentioned the transitional provisions. So here the discuss about the unit 5 of GST is what is the recovery of tax and who is the liability of paid tax and what are the liability to pay tax in specified cases and final is transitional provisions. So these all are the GST Act about the recovery of tax in final stages. So we are giving some more detailed about the GST in elaborately of recovery of tax. So finally, what are the recovery of tax in GST, who is the liability of the GST and what are the transactional provision of GST mentioned here briefly and also in detailed. So thank you. Once again, I thank to all for listening our class of basics of GST. We had covered in 5 units of the basics of GST. First unit is discussed about the introduction of GST and also the road begins of GST. And the next one is GST is what are the rules and regulations followed by the GSTs. So draft model GST law and positives, negatives, levy of GST, territorial and jurisdiction of GST, taxable event and considerations, levy and collection of GST, composition levy, place and time of GST, and definition of GST, time and supply of GST. These all are the covered in Unit 1. And Unit 2 covered the topic is valuation, special transactions, job work, electronics commerce, input tax credit, and input service distributors, and refunds, the refunds rules, and interest on refunds. These are already covered in the Unit 3. Next, Unit 3. Sorry, before that we are seeing the Unit 2 covered these all other topics, and now discuss about the Unit 3 agenda is compliances. The compliance is registration of GST and made the invoices and credit and debit notes, payment of tax and TDS, TCS, and how to filing the returns forms, and what are the accounts and records we should maintain, and also assessment, audit and inspection of records, and what are the interest, penalty and prosecution of the any fault made or any not paid having some other disputes, and also settlements. These all are the covered by third unit. And fourth unit covered the appeals, demand and CGST, SGST, IGST appeals, and also what are the dispute and alternate disputes, and resolution mechanism, authority of advance ruling and settlement of the cases. And finally, fifth unit, recovery of tax, liability to pay tax, liability to pay tax in specified cases, and final transitional goods, transitional provisions. These all are the basics of GST. Okay, once again, I thank to you all.